Chrystia Freeland's remarks ring with a jarring note of hypocrisy, starkly contrasting with her actions at home. This issue uncovers deep-rooted anxieties and fuels ideological divides, with public reactions and media reports highlighting the widespread cultural and ideological rifts in society.
Does Canada accept the results of the election in Venezuela? And if not, what is Canada going to do about it?
Thank you for the question. Canada, like many of our other allies, like many of the world's democracies, has serious concerns about the election in Venezuela. And we're working closely with our partners. I do want to take a moment to really voice my support for the brave people of Venezuela, the brave democracy leaders of Venezuela. It takes real courage to stand up for democracy in the face of an authoritarian regime. Millions of people in Venezuela have been doing that, and I want them to know that Canada recognizes their courage and determination. And Canada has been supporting the democratic opposition and condemning an increasingly severe authoritarian regime in Venezuela for many years now. I want the people of Venezuela, the Democrats of Venezuela, to know that Canada stands with them and recognizes that they are fighting hard for democracy and freedom, and they deserve it, just as all of us do.
Freeland's comments on Venezuela's elections seem especially hypocritical when juxtaposed with her handling of domestic protests, like the trucker protests in Canada. The public finds it contradictory that she lauds the bravery of Venezuelans facing authoritarianism, while simultaneously claiming her suppression of dissent in Canada upholds democracy and freedom. This duality paints Canada as a nation that suppresses democracy at home while championing it abroad, leading to accusations of political double standards and gaslighting. Freeland's statements highlight a glaring inconsistency between her support for Venezuela's democratization and her approach to domestic protests. This discrepancy undermines the reliability of her words, casting doubt on her sincerity. It underscores the importance of aligning actions with values and the personal responsibility of leaders to maintain the integrity of their actions. Freeland's remarks are likely to provoke a variety of reactions. While her supporters might feel validated and inspired by her stance on democracy in Venezuela, those aware of her past actions at home feel frustrated and skeptical of her sincerity. The perceived inconsistency between her international positions and domestic policies leads to cognitive dissonance among those trying to reconcile these differences. This dissonance can deepen polarization and foster distrust in political leaders. The public's response is likely to be split along ideological lines. Those unaware of the full context may praise Freeland for her stand on the international stage. In contrast, Canadians familiar with the truth view her remarks as disingenuous and hypocritical, exacerbating feelings of distrust and division.